Hello children, today we are going to read understand one poem, that is why English is so hard. You must be thinking, no, English is very easy, I get good marks also in English. But if we go deep into it, we can understand some points which we should keep in mind, right? So poem number 12, why English is so hard, page number 26. See your children, you all must be knowing nouns. Yes, any name, place, animal, thing. And in that we also know singular and plural. Correct? Singular is one and plural means many. Right? So we use certain rules for doing our plurals. So we add es, or we remove y and we write ies. Correct? Now this poet is having a confusion. We will begin with a box and the plural is boxes. So we know that singular is box and the plural is boxes. But the plural of ox should be oxen, not oxes. Now, but the plural of ox, one ox and many oxen. And it's not oxes. Why is that so? So the poet is confused. Are they? If the plural of box is boxes, why not ox and oxes? Why is it ox and oxen? Right? So again, he has lot of confusion. Now in the second paragraph, he's saying, you may find a lone mouse or a whole lot of mice. Single mouse, only one mouse. And what is the plural of mouse? Mice. Any, that is mice. But the plural of a house is houses and not hice. So the poet is confused. Array. Again there is confusion. Oh my god. First they said mouse and mice. But now they are saying house and houses. Why not hice? Yes. In the third paragraph, if the plural of man is men. So we all know what is the plural of man? Plural of man is men. One man, many men. Why shouldn't the plural of pan be called pen? So this boy is in confusion. Oh my god. Now you said okay, pan, men. Now pan, pen. No. Why they are calling pans? What is the plural of pan? Pans. And I speak of a foot and you show me your feet. So one single foot and feet. But I give you a boot, would a pair be called beat? But now if I give a set, though, two, boot, right? So it is called boots. The poet is saying, why not beat? That one may be that and three may be those. Now, whichever is nearby to us and it is in single. So we say that. And whichever is nearer to us and it is in plural form, we say those. Single ek hi nazdik hai, toh hum log that bolte hain. And single nazdik wala jo zyada hai, usko hum those bolte hain. So again the poet is saying, if that one may be that and three may be those, yet the plural of hat would never be hose. Now plural, what is the plural of hat? Hats, correct? And not hose. So this poem is all about the confusion of the small boy about English. The masculine pronouns are he, his and him. Now masculine. Who are masculine? We call the male or the boys. They are masculine gender. And pronouns? Correct. The words which are used in place of noun. So they are he, his, him. लड़के लोगों को हम लोग क्या रेफर करते हैं? ही इज अ बॉय, इट इज हिज बैग, राइट? देन हिम, दे लाइक्ड हिम. बट इमेजिन द फेमिनाइन, शी, शीज एंड हिम. बट फॉर फेमिनाइन जेंडर, द गर्ल्स के लिए हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं? ओनली शी बोलते हैं एंड नॉट शी, शीज एंड शिम. So our English, I think you all will agree, is the trickiest language you ever did see. So in at the end, this boy or the poet is saying that our English is very tricky language, right? And it is not the same. So we need to understand the concepts, the base properly. Otherwise, it would be very difficult for us to understand or write English. Is it clear? So we should be knowing each and every concept clearly. What is noun? What is a plural form of any single word? We should be knowing it very properly. Is it clear? So at the end, the poet is thinking that though English is a funny language, tricky language, but it is also very confusing. So you must be thinking, oh, English is very easy, but it is very tricky. You should know all the rules properly. Is it clear? Yes, children. So read the poem, understand it. If you are not understanding, please tell me. I will again explain it to you. Okay? Bye-bye.